In the last episodes, you have heard a lot about our experiences with plastic in and around the water. This time, we will let some other people do a little bit of the talking.
Throughout my whole journey, I've been seeing the plastic on the shorelines, and it was really getting worse and worse. And I was, after coming back there, it just had increased to a crazy amount that we had cleaned the whole island. Like it was an island where, you know, how long was it? It was maybe 100 meter beach on both sides, like kind of like an oval. We cleaned the whole island, and the next day, it was already full of them. Like there was already 2 full bags of plastic bottles the next day when we came to clean again. So it was, and we had done like beach cleanups before, but you know, there's usually no infrastructure and you can't put all the trash on your boat because it's just impossible. I mean, yes, there's something close by, but you know, the logistics are just really complicated. So what we did was just burn it because we were thinking, you know, if it stays in the ocean, then it breaks down, it goes into food chain and it spreads more and more. If you burn it, yes, you pollute the air, but as long as you're able to, if you get like a fairly high temperature, then you have a little bit less toxins, but you know, this is all assumption, but it was kind of more like then it was gone and you felt it was feeling better than leaving it on the beach.
Yeah.
But we also, knew that obviously it wasn't a good solution and it didn't feel good to burn the plastic also because it's, you know, precious material.
During the last 6 years living and traveling on my sailboat Carl, I have witnessed the drastic effects of plastic pollution along many shorelines, but also out on the ocean. As an individual, I try to reduce the amount of plastic, especially single-use plastic, that I use in my daily life. I pick up plastic trash wherever I go, and we try to raise awareness for the issue of plastic pollution on our planet through our platform In-Mocean. Another way to fight the problem is to address governments and companies about the urgency to address this threat. One way to do this is to help collect data to show the extent of the pollution of the ocean with plastic. That's why I decided to build a microplastic trawler and to take microplastic samples throughout my onward journey.
And this is where Precious Plastic comes in. An organization that aims to make plastic recycling an easily available option for everyone. They offer blueprints to build your own shredder, extruder, and more machines for you to make new stuff out of discarded plastics. By further simplifying the machines to mostly manual use, the team of In-Mocean hopes to engage more island communities, even in the remotest corners of the world.
Voyage is not just the precious plastic with the machines, but like the recycling or cleaning oceans in general. But it's going really well. I think you've seen that we just had the workshop with the little baskets that we made with the village, and it was really exciting to see, you know, people being excited about the recycling and totally kicking in and wanting to learn how to do the baskets, and like the kids were really proud to have them and they really got the message. And so that was, yeah, it was really inspiring. And the people that I had brought with us from this island, they were so excited about it that they're like, "Wow, we should do another one in the village next to this island where we are right now, and we know people there, and we can make it happen." And I'm like, "Yeah, cool." So it was a good booster for the whole project.
Plastic pollution is plastic where it shouldn't be. It's in the sea and on the beach, and it's causing harm. We're using more plastic than ever. It's durable, cheap to produce, and we're consuming it at staggering rates. Current estimates show that at least 8 million pieces of plastic are entering the oceans every single day. Two-thirds of plastic comes straight from land-based sources, litter being left on the beach, or washed down rivers and drains from litter being dropped in towns and cities. It comes from industry spills, badly managed landfill sites, and bins near the coast or by being flushed down the loo. The remainder is lost at sea, such as containers going overboard or lost fishing gear. Luckily, in many parts of the world, people are becoming more and more aware of this issue. Nonprofit organizations and motivated individuals step up, where governments tend to be too slow to react. They organize beach cleanups, recycling workshops, and community engagement events. Also, sailors and cruisers start to organize cleanup events amongst themselves and clear remote beaches from plastic debris. An effort we should all applaud. If you are one of those caring cruisers, please let us know, as we hope to put together a full episode showing some of the dedicated people cleaning our oceans. As of this moment, beach cleanups are still the easiest and most efficient way to remove plastics from the ocean, and every piece that is not in the environment does count. And for those sailors out there who want to do even more, there is a way to do that too, by becoming a citizen scientist and help researchers with their data collection.
The Lady is a smaller, less expensive, and easy to build open source alternative to the current scientific standard, the Manta Trawl, which costs $3,500 instead of $500, and is a lot heavier and requires specialized equipment and skills to create. After downloading the instruction plan on 5gyres.com/DIY-trawl, we started looking for the parts in Panama.
Traditional manta trawls are big and expensive. The Lady Trawl offers a smaller and much cheaper option. There are also mini mantas out there for an even smaller footprint on board, which is the option that we are going for this coming summer.
Okay, this is our cat poop sample. That just happened because I shook it and it's like now looks like poop. So I'm gonna dig in now and try to see if I find any microplastic.
If you are interested in microplastic, ways to tackle the problem, but also ways to get involved, help with research as well as solutions, please do get in touch. Microplastics will be one of our main topics this season, and we would love to hear more about your angle and approach to the topic. So make sure to let us know in the comments below, and we hope to see you back here soon to learn more. Special thank you to White Spot Pirates and In-Mocean. They provided a fair bit of the footage this time around, and are currently running workshops in Panama, so make sure to check on them as well. That is it from our end for the week. See you again in 7 days.